It was the time of the judges in Israel. The famine was over in the Promised Land. The deaths of Naomi's husband and two sons had taken its toll. Naomi was returning to her home in the land of Judah with her two surviving daughters-in-law. She turned and urged Orpah and Ruth to go back to Moab.
Turn back, my daughters, go your way, for I am too old to have a husband. Even if I should have a husband tonight and should also bear sons, would you wait for them till they were grown?
It was to be a parting of the ways. Orpah kissed Naomi and walked away. Orpah had loved the God of Israel, but not enough. She walked off the pages of Scripture and was never heard of again. But Ruth made a decision of the heart for God and his people.
Entreat me not to leave you or to turn back from following after you. For wherever you go, I will go. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried.
And so Ruth joined herself to Naomi and never left her. Ruth was greatly blessed by God for standing with Naomi and her people, Israel. She married Boaz and was later to become the great-grandmother of King David and an earthly ancestor to the promised Messiah, Yeshua.
The Bible contains the most beautiful love story in all the world. It's the story of Ruth and Naomi. Ruth joined herself to the people of Israel through her trust and faith in the God of Israel. Likewise, the church has come into the commonwealth of Israel through the blood of the Messiah, Jesus. Won't you come with us as we go to Jerusalem now to see the heart of the ministry of Christian Friends of Israel as we minister in the Spirit of Ruth.
Christian Friends of Israel was called into being by the Lord as a prophetic ministry in the last days, before the return of the Lord Jesus to reign upon David's throne in Jerusalem. The call of the ministry is threefold: to proclaim God's prophetic agenda in these last days, part of which is to see the church restored to its Jewish and biblical roots, to stand with Israel in exposing anti-Israel bias and misinformation in the media, as well as standing for the fulfillment of the purposes of God through prayer, intercession, literature and publications, teaching material, Bible videos, audio cassette distribution, annual conferences, the World Wide Web, and travel. To show the love of Jesus, the Messiah, to the people of Israel by standing with them in their hour of need and through the various outreach ministries of Christian Friends of Israel. Israel today is at war. She has been at war for virtually all the 5.5 decades since her miraculous rebirth as a nation at the hand of God. In the last decade, Israel's war for survival has taken a new turn as she has attempted to make peace with an Arab population living within Israel's biblical heartland, the Palestinian people.
Today, what we see indeed is Israel has been basically sucked into a war that it did not want, with the Palestinian autonomy, going into the Palestinian cities. Israel is now being attacked by the Lebanese Hezbollah with the support of Syria, Iran, Iraq. This is a concerted, synchronized effort by the Islamic world to shift all the attention to Israel and to blame Israel. The European Union has joined in this lynching of Israel. Unfortunately, there are many countries which call themselves Christians, and they are not Christians, and they are all participating in the lynching of Israel.
I remember looking at some documentaries on the Jewish people and learning about the Holocaust. I was 22 years old. And when I saw the documentaries of the tragedy of the Jewish people and the Holocaust and how they were being treated, the way they were being starved to death, and I asked myself, where was the church? And my heart was broken. And I asked that question, I still ask it today, where was the church in that time? And no one seems to give me a straight answer.
For those of us who are Christians, the question is this: are we going to join in the lynching of Israel too? Or are we, as the church, going to stand with Israel as Ruth stood with Naomi?
Hopefully the Lord will use me to touch the church, to see that we need to respect and love our elder brother, the Jewish people, and thank them, even though they don't have the revelation of Jesus yet. But they have given us the Torah, they gave us the Tanakh, and if it wasn't for that, to see that Jesus is indeed the Messiah, our faith would be nothing. And I feel like we owe them a debt of love. And I'm here because I owe them a debt of love.
Today in Israel, innocent blood is being shed on the streets almost daily. The nation is not only fighting a war against terrorism, but she is also fighting a propaganda war against the nations that try to legitimize Palestinian terrorism against Israel. Both these forms of warfare against Israel have taken their toll with the Israeli population as a whole, but none more than the victims of terrorism and their families. In 2001, Christian Friends of Israel began a new arm of its ministry following an incident which, if it were not for the protection of the Lord, could have cost the lives of CFI Jerusalem's international directors, Ray and Sharon Sanders.
Sharon and I decided to spend our 28th wedding anniversary overnight in a hotel in Tel Aviv. This is the first time we had done this since coming to Israel in June of 1985. Little did we realize that it was going to be such a memorable experience.
After having dinner, Ray and Sharon took an evening walk along the seafront esplanade in Tel Aviv.
And then all of a sudden, to our shock, we heard this huge explosion. And initially I thought it was a car bomb because it was so loud. And people were indecisive whether to run towards it or away from it. So we just waited momentarily, because oftentimes in cases like that, if there's one bomb, there'll be another one. And suddenly the police and the ambulances rushed to the scene. We decided to walk across the street and just view the whole carnage from our vantage point at that time.
At that moment, 19 young Russian immigrants who had been lining up outside the Dolphinarium discotheque were blown into eternity. More died later, and scores were injured. Ray and Sharon saw it all happen.
When we were about 175 yards from the bomb blast, or about a minute and 20 seconds, if we'd have continued walking along the promenade, we'd have been right there. And who knows? In fact, where we were walking, one of those who was killed by a nail, pierced his heart right on the very area where we were walking. So we thank God for his protection at that significant time.
The Dolphinarium bombing shocked the nation and the international community.
As a result of this experience, Sharon felt in particular that we should begin a new project called Under His Wings to minister to those who are suffering from terrorist attacks. And so we've initiated this project, and so we're starting to go to the homes of these victims and to minister God's love to them, but also to help them financially, because they have a lot of medical expenses and things that they need help with.
Since the inception of Project Under His Wings in 2001, terrorism against Israel has increased dramatically. One of the worst times was Passover in 2002. Among the many victims that CFI assisted then was security guard Anatoly Gerslitzer. His legs were badly injured when a female Palestinian suicide bomber detonated herself just a few feet from him. His fellow security guard and an Israeli teenager were killed. CFI's Helen Floyd and Yaakov Yulis, a Jewish rabbi who works alongside Christian Friends of Israel, went to see Anatoly in the hospital. As with all terrorist victims CFI staff meet, they presented him with a certificate of courage and sacrifice on behalf of his country. A Star of David pillow, a lovely quilt, and financial assistance.
Comfort. Yes, comfort my people, says your God.
The outreach project under his wings ministry also encourages wounded soldiers in a similar way.
We make these for the soldiers.
Wow.
That's why I said.
Shimon Navon served in the Lebanon War in 1982. Later, he was called into the Army Reserve during the First Intifada. One night, he was on patrol in an army jeep near Hebron when a Molotov cocktail was thrown through the window. His companions managed to escape, but he was trapped in the fiery inferno.
It was midnight, it's very dark. Everybody thought that I was outside. When I feel that I'm going to die and I scream, I must to live.
Yes.
And then when I scream this, they recognize that I'm stuck in the jeep. Then come, take me outside, take care of me, ambulance coming, and I was wounded very hard, and they take me to the hospital with the helicopter.
Shimon underwent more than 45 surgical operations in the next few years.
You can see I wounded in my hand, and I wounded in my face, and all my body. And the burn, I think it's one of the worst wounded that it's so suffer. And I try to be all the time the optimist. And I think that in our difficult country, in all what happened to all of us, and now in this second intifada, to be all the time optimist, because we have a wonderful country and we have wonderful people.
I'm sorry. You paid a price for a country that is the most special country on earth.
Yeah.
In Israel's modern history, more than 20,000 Israeli soldiers have sacrificed their lives in the defense of the nation. Thousands more, like Shimon, have been maimed or disfigured for life. It is important for Christians to understand that men like Shimon, though they may not know it, are defending the Jewish people's God-given rights to the land of Israel.
He has remembered his covenant forever, the word which he commanded for 1,000 generations, the covenant which he made with Abraham and his oath to Isaac and confirmed it to Jacob for a statute, to Israel for an everlasting covenant, saying, "To you I give the land of Canaan as the allotment of your inheritance."
Part of CFI's mandate is to proclaim the promises of God concerning Israel to the church and to the people of Israel. The publications department of CFI plays an important role in countering misinformation in the media, both through publications, such as the monthly Israel News Digest, and through news commentaries via email and CFI's worldwide website.
Currently, CFI has 24 representatives in the nations. One of my main jobs is to supply the representatives that we have with information, whether it's about our new projects or if it's our current brochures. And all of the information that we have that is generated here in the CFI headquarters goes to all of the representatives. They, in turn, take this information and translate it into their own languages and therefore distribute it into their country, making known the purpose of CFI, what the ministry is about, and giving all the people in the nations an opportunity to bless the people in the nation of Israel.
Mark. Marita Brokenshaw is Christian Friends of Israel's senior desktop publisher and graphic artist. Apart from preparing the ministry's publications for printing, including CFIs for Zion's sake, she has designed a series of scripture posters to encourage the people of Israel that there is a God who cares for them.
We're giving out these posters to all the people in the land, and we want to encourage them to read the scriptures and turn their hearts back to God. And the one poster that is doing very, very well is the soldier poster. And we go to the top of Israel all the way down to the bottom, and groups of people have gone out to army bases, and they have responded to this very favorably. And I cannot seem to do enough of these. So I'm making some more. So far we've made about 25,000. So I have really enjoyed this project very much.
An important part of standing with Israel in the spirit of Ruth is through prayer and intercession. The Lord Jesus will not be returning to Jerusalem as the capital of an Islamic Palestinian state. He will be returning to a Jewish people, restored to their land, to Jerusalem, and to himself, their brother and Messiah.
I have set watchmen on your walls, O Jerusalem, who shall never hold their peace day or night. You who make mention of the Lord, do not keep silent, and give him no rest till he establishes, until he makes Jerusalem the praise of the earth.
My job in CFI is involved with our Watchman's Prayer Ministry. We believe there are many, many intercessors all over the world called to be watchmen on the walls of Jerusalem. And we here on the spot put out prayer materials which help those watchmen pray into what is going on in Israel today in the light of Scripture, so that we're actually praying for the fulfillment of God's purposes, not judging by our own human understanding, but judging according to Scripture. And so I compile every month a letter which goes out in the mail on subscription and also on the email, the Watchman's Prayer Letter. And this includes requests alongside Scripture that are relevant to the events going on in Israel at this time. And alongside that, I also write every week an email publication called On Watch in Jerusalem, which is really more crisis praying. It's praying into the news. I try and anticipate what will be happening in the next week so that I can alert intercessors to pray into those things, that the will of God will be accomplished in and through his dealings with the people of Israel.
Another valuable prophetic tool that enables intercessors to pray intelligently for Israel is Lance Lambert's Middle East Updates, which CFI distributes every 3 to 4 months. Yet another important part of the intercessory ministry of Christian Friends of Israel is the Wall of Prayer.
The vision for Wall of Prayer was born out of the Gulf War, and it began in 1992. And the vision is to have believers in the body of Messiah in the nations committing to pray, not just for Jerusalem as we're exhorted in the scriptures or for Israel, but to commit to pray for a specific place. It could be a kibbutz, a Jewish community, a mushav, an Arab village. Every area is we have covered.
Altogether, there are nearly 1,800 locations throughout the land that are covered through the Wall of Prayer by people praying in almost 100 countries around the world.
From time to time, when we have transportation and we can leave our desks, we can go out to the areas in Israel and visit some of the kibbutzim, settlements, moshavim, and we get to talk to the people and we get to find out from them what is on their heart. And that way we can know what the heartbeat is of the people in the land
who are praying for this place, who have no comprehension of what it's like, of the people.
Mm-hmm. So just watching CNN is enough to biased position.
Yes, well, we want to represent a true picture, mm-hmm, in line with, you know, scripture, with the Tanakh, mm-hmm, and
I have three boys, 17, 15, and 11. And although our lives haven't changed drastically, small things like my 11-year-old, who is so used to just going up playing basketball in the evening with his friends, we as mothers are prohibiting them for the first time in a place where I wouldn't see my kids 4, 5, 6 hours. I never really worried about it. Or my oldest, who is 17, who will be going to the Army next year, which I can't even think about, so I'm not going to. I'm going to pray for him too.
Yeah.
Three boys. Absolutely. There's nothing more I can give this country.
Every male, every female goes to the Army for 3 years or 2 years, and after that, after
this particular location that the Wall of Prayer team visited was Kibbutz Ma'ale HaChamisha in the Judean hills to the west of Jerusalem. Founded in 1938 and with a current membership of 180 families, the kibbutz borders on the Green Line and could find itself adjacent to hostile territory in the event of Palestinian statehood.
Being part of the Wall of Prayer through Christian Friends of Israel gives me a unique and precious opportunity to pray for a small area of the land. We are a group praying for a kibbutz called Ma'ale HaChamisha.
I've never been prayed for before. I'm honored. I think it's absolutely beautiful.
We're praying for the Lord's protection and safety during these turbulent years, and also for a great outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon them, that they will know that Yeshua is their Messiah.
And if it helps, I might go to prayer too. I just might. I pray that there won't be a reason to send my three boys to the Army. That is in my prayers.
There's never been a time in Israel's history more than now when she needs the support and the prayers of the body of Messiah in the nations.
These are scriptures that we've produced and published with the scriptures in Hebrew and English from the Tanakh to encourage people to turn to the Bible again and begin to read the Word of God.
It's just awesome for them to think that there would be Gentile Christian believers who would come to this land at a time like this and take the time to go and visit and encourage them, and then we let them know that we're praying for them.
Currently on our database we have 4,500 names, but bearing in mind that one name can represent that one person or a larger group, a prayer group of 15, 25, and in one instance we have a church in the Philippines of 1,000 members who are registered praying for a specific place in the land.
While the Christian intercessors out in the nations are involved in the defense of Israel in a spiritual sense, the Israel Defense Forces are very much the guardian of the nation in a physical sense. Indeed, the military protection of Israel is also part of the fulfillment of the purposes of God in the lead up to the return of the Lord Jesus to Jerusalem. For this reason, Christian Friends of Israel has a ministry of encouragement to those who militarily defend the nation in the form of Project Care Package.
Project Care Package is, we send out, it's a ministry that outreaches to the soldiers. And what we do is we give three times a year care packages for our soldiers. It's during the times of the high holidays for the Jewish people, one of which is the New Year, the Jewish New Year, Rosh Hashanah, Hanukkah, and Pesach, or Passover. And in these care packages, we prepare shampoo, underarm deodorant, toothpastes, toothbrushes, shaving cream, skin lotion for the ladies, and socks, and it just goes on. Sometimes it varies from time to time. And we always are well received, and every time we go up there, they always have like an open reception for us and wanting to bless us because we bless them. The Israeli army feels like we're really behind them. They're really touched that we pray for them. They're even more touched when they see our publications about them. And it really warms their heart to know that Christians around the world are praying for them. And they really know we're sincere. And they usually cry. Usually they'll have tears in their eyes.
One of the great prophetic signs of the time is the return of the Jewish exiles to the land of Israel from the four corners of the earth. and especially from the land of the north, as the ancient prophets foretold. During the last decade of the 20th century, 1 million Jews returned from the former Soviet Union and Ethiopia. One of Christian Friends of Israel's main outreach ministries is directed towards Olim, or new immigrants. This outreach ministry is based at the CFI Distribution Center, strategically located next to Jerusalem's central bus station.
We opened our first distribution center in March of 1990 as an expression of Christian love and support for the people coming to Israel from the former Soviet Union. Since that time until now, we've ministered to more than 200,000 of these immigrants. And more recently, we're getting a number of immigrants coming to us for help from Argentina. This gives us the opportunity to express Christian support for the homecoming of the Jewish people at this time. And as you can see, we're getting a number from the former Soviet Union that are coming for assistance. We not only help them with clothing, but with financial gifts that they have need for hearing aids and food vouchers, also household items. There's a variety of ways in which we can help these new immigrants, and basically just to express to them our support for their homecoming as they adjust to a new culture, a new society, a new language, and getting a job and everything. We just feel it's a very appropriate way of Christian support for the Jewish people at this time.
The distribution center operates entirely through generous donations and love gifts from Christians in the nations.
Jesus said, "Inasmuch as you have done it unto the least of these, my brethren, you have done it unto me."
Scheduled large clothing shipments of highest quality clothing from every continent on earth arrive regularly for Project Open Gates and also for Project Doors of Hope. Then it's all hands on deck to get the 20-foot or 40-foot containers unloaded.
New immigrants who have been in the country for less than 1 year, they are allowed to come to Open Gates 4 times. And when they come for the first time, they get something new as a gift, but mostly our help is second-hand clothing. It seems to be really helpful for many new immigrants that they thank us, that many of the immigrants who have been here 4 times, that they tell us that actually this help was really, really needed and helped them to settle down in this country. Not only the actual material help, but also the support that they get, and particularly in these kind of difficult times when there's a lot of opposition against Israel, people here feel that our support for them is really precious because we show that they are not alone.
Another department at CFI's distribution center that ministers to the poor and needy in the land is called Project Doors of Hope.
Doors of Hope was instituted primarily for immigrants who are coming from different parts of the world. We see immigrants from Russia, Ethiopia, and we expect to see more from various countries as the time goes on. And for those who have been in the land more than a year, we are here to help them with clothing needs, with basic necessities of their household. We see various ages, all the way from senior citizens down to little children who are in needy families or single-parent families. And we are also able to help needy Israelis, those who are native-born Israelis, with their needs as well in this tough economic time.
She's here to see Lynn today in Doors of Hope. And did you come to get some clothing or something?
In Doors of Hope, people come to us from every walk of life in Israel. And Proverbs 31:20 tells us that the virtuous woman, she opens her arms to the poor. In other words, she embraces them and extends her hands to the needy.
I think it's wonderful. She's a special lady.
A special branch of Doors of Hope is the CFI Bridal Department.
The Bridal Department is representative of the day when the voice of the bridegroom and the voice of the bride together will fill the streets of Jerusalem with their joyful sound.
This is Eleanor, and she's a bride, and she's come to have a look at some of the bride dresses and to try some on.
the bridal department is a blessed department. It's a great blessing to the people in Israel.
Do you like the satin tie?
Yeah.
Or netting, satin?
The dresses are beautiful gowns that have been sent from all over the world, especially America and Europe and Singapore. And they are sent to bless the people in Israel by believers.
That's beautiful.
Many, many brides have been here and really enjoyed the blessing of this department. Plus the fact there's no charge for them to hire the gowns, which obviously saves them money. And it's a great privilege to be here, to be able to see a bride transformed and to be blessed on her wedding day.
Dress was nice. I liked it very much. Garrett liked it. Pam was very kind, and we were blessed by this yellow thorn. And also for Garrett, it's kind of difficult to find a suit in a short time.
Just for my size.
Yeah. So we found it. It was really nice, and thank you, CFI.
The body of Messiah in the land is the present-day remnant of Israel, or first fruit of what is to come. It is a small but growing spiritual force in the land, which in the Lord's time will culminate in the fulfillment of the proclamation of the Apostle Paul that all Israel will be saved, and the consequential return of the Lord Jesus. Project First Fruits is a support ministry for the household of faith in Israel today.
Ministry of First Fruits has developed out of a need, really. In days past, we used to help various ministries from the tithe account. But of course, as the body developed in the land, there became a greater necessity to be able to do something on a proper basis. So First Fruits developed out of that, specifically to deal with the body of believers in the land of Israel. These, of course, are Arab and Jewish. We're all brothers in Jesus. So yeah, it's grown, and it's growing, still growing, obviously, because the believers in the land are still growing, praise the Lord.
The Christian Church of Jesus Christ had its origins in the nation of Israel, and particularly in the Jewish Messiah. In Romans chapter 15, the Apostle Paul urged the Gentiles to support the believers in Jerusalem.
There are many, many people in Israel that are believers, but are also financially in difficulty. You know, it's an expensive place to live this.
It pleased those Gentiles to make a contribution for the poor among the saints who are in Jerusalem. For if the Gentiles have been partakers of their spiritual things, their duty is also to minister to them in material things.
We want to assist in the development of the body, so we try and help in the development of the different fellowships. We try and help in their financial needs, whether it be for building, for equipment within the fellowship, just to help them grow. And in evangelism, you know, I mean, we can't go and stand on the streets, but we can help them to do the job that God has given us all to do, to spread the word.
As coordinator of Project First Fruits, Rod travels around the country to encourage the pastors and leaders.
Hi, brother. Welcome, brother. Nice to see you. Bless you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Elias Jubran is an Arab pastor with a heart for Israel and the Jewish people. Based in northern Galilee, he is involved in a ministry of reconciliation. When Elias first contacted First Fruits, he was planning a reconciliation gathering for Jewish and Arab believers.
So I told him about my special ministry, like an Arab one that works among Jews and among new immigrants.
It's a very blessed door that the Lord have opened for me. And I will thank the Lord also that he support also this work through Christian Friends of Israel, CFI, and Brother Rhodes especially, that he came and visited and asked what the needs and he support and he encouraged us so very much in this.
We helped to finance it because of the lack of funding available at the time, and we were invited. So Penny and I went up there and we spent a weekend with these guys, and just to hear the teaching that was coming forth from Arab pastors, from Jewish pastors, on the one new man, and to be experiencing the one new man in a time of great difficulty in the land, it was a great blessing.
It's a blessed way, and I am thank the Lord in this part that as an Arab people that can work with Jewish and they can have the real peace together and to show the chief of peace, the Lord Jesus, in our life, in our work, it's a very important thing.
The nation of Israel was reborn in the Promised Land from the ashes of the Holocaust in Europe. The shadow of the Holocaust still hangs over the nation of Israel, and the number of survivors still living is diminishing. Those that remain still bear the emotional and physical scars of the atrocities that were inflicted upon them and their loved ones. They went into the concentration camps, and emotionally, they never came out. They are a deeply wounded people.
Haben nicht gekannt, das sprechen. Wir sind überhaupt keine Menschen gewesen. Wir haben gefühlt bei sich, dass er mir nicht, dass er mir so will, ich weiß nicht, bei Heimes tut mir besser pflegen. Das ist überhaupt keine Menschen. Keine Beziehung wie ein Mensch. Kinder haben sie genommen, den Kopf gekloppt und die Wand. Wissen Sie, kleine Kinder. Und die haben die Kinder zugenommen, die haben alles. Das war schrecklich.
Sophia survived 2 years in Auschwitz. Before that, she had been herded into the Warsaw Ghetto, where all the members of her family were murdered by the Gestapo and the SS. One day, they came for her sister.
Aber wir haben gelebt zufrieden. Wir haben gelebt. Wir haben jeden Tag und mir hat Angst wegen dem Tod. Wir werden nicht leben. Ja, jeden Tag. Mir hat Schreck große. Wenn die Deutschen gedacht umbringen, die Menschen haben sie genommen. Wer das ist gegangen, das egal. Ja, gearbeitet, nicht gearbeitet. Da haben sie rausgenommen von Abteilung meiner Schwester. Habe gesehen, meine Schwester nimmt man weg von der Abteilung. Habe ich geschrieben, ich wollte mitgehen mit meiner Schwester. Sie haben gesagt, sie geht arbeiten, aber das war nicht wahr. Die haben genommen, auf ab umzubringen, das Gaseben.
After her beloved sister was taken, Sophia spent most of her time in hiding from the Nazi death squads, sometimes in the most appalling conditions.
Und ich mit dem Mädchen, mit dem Gewehr, ein paar Mädchen haben sich dort versteckt. Wissen Sie, haben sich dort versteckt. Und dem Schmutz, das war viel Kack, was die Leute haben nicht gehabt. Das alles Dreck und alles Schmutz war dort. Habe ich genommen und dort mit dem Mädchen hereingegangen in dem Schmutz. Sei weder in dem Schmutz, als das Leben verliehen.
I feel very deeply they have not survived accidentally. They have survived the Holocaust through many or by many miracles. And we see, when we hear their stories, we see that this is the hand of God. Of course, they themselves can't see it yet. And we tell them, and more they see it also. And I see and I know God wants or has an eternal purpose with them and wants to reach with his love out to them for eternity.
The focus of CFI's Forsake Them Not Holocaust ministry is to comfort many survivors and to bring the healing balm of the Lord's love into their lives.
Well, we find that their greatest need is to be visited and not to be forgotten. To have visitors, they're so lonely. A lot of them are isolated and financially not in a good position at all, and they don't get out much. And with so many things happening in Israel, so much terrorism and fear, often they're isolated and by themselves.
We go and visit Holocaust survivors regularly in their homes, and we try just to build up a relationship, friendship, and to show them that we have not forgotten them, that we love them, that there are Christians who love them. We help them whatever they need, to go to the doctor or to go shopping with them. And I experience that this brings healing, but it takes time and it takes prayer.
CFI's Forsake Them Not team members are trained to handle trauma victims. They care for hundreds of Holocaust survivors on a regular basis. When a survivor is visited for the first time, they are presented with a quilt or a blanket of love from Christians in the nations.
They've been knit by Christians from all over the world. They send them to us, and lovely quilts we have here. And we're just so pleased to have them. And it's just amazing when the Holocaust survivors receive one of these blankets. It just really comforts them, and they are touched.
Through the year, Christian Friends of Israel hosts numerous gatherings for Holocaust survivors at CFI headquarters to commemorate Holocaust Remembrance Day or to celebrate the Jewish feasts.
People need the Lord. People need the Lord. When will we realize?
It is a time of laughing together, a time of crying together, and a time when relationships are built and bonded together.
As we know, some 6 million gave their lives as the enemies of the Jewish people tried to eradicate even the name of the Jewish
people.
Today we have a different enemy.
Сегодня у нас другой враг.
But with the same goal.
Но цель у него все та же.
It was an unparalleled time. And those of you here today, present,
и те, которые сегодня присутствуют здесь,
you survived. You survived because the hand of God brought you through.
И вы выжили только потому, что рука Бога.
And yet your eyes have seen the death of so many people.
Глаза ваши видели.
You know, I wondered to myself, where were all the Christian voices on behalf of the Jewish people? There were the rescuers. There was a German pastor, Dietrich Bonhoeffer.
Был немецкий пастор Dietrich.
They hung him because he taught his congregations to stand with Israel.
During each event, an opportunity is always given for the Holocaust survivors to respond.
Когда мы видим ваши добрые сердца, ваши милые лица, ваши глаза,
your kind hearts, your kind faces, your wonderful eyes,
это нам очень дорого. Это нам.
It's so dear, so precious.
Это укрепляет нас в нашей вере в то, что мы не одиноки.
It strengthens in our faith that we are not alone.
The love of Jesus is unconditional. It is also deep. One has to be willing to go wherever he calls, do whatever it takes, and be, as Paul said, to the Jew as a Jew, and to the Gentile as a Gentile.
I'm inspired, I'm inspired, I'm inspired, I'm inspired.
to reach those that are forgotten, hurting, alone, the victimized, the poor, and the needy. When you have the love of Jesus in your heart, you'll find ways to express it. And you will find out quickly how people respond to His amazing love. The CFI staff are all called servants of the Lord from many nations around the world. Each one has answered the call of God to serve the Jewish people in the land of Israel.
All of us are just really honored and humbled and just grateful to be here to be servants of the Lord and to bless His people in any way that He would, in any gift that He would give us to bless them and to love them. And we're the ones that receive the blessing from it.
Yes, I feel that it's a great privilege to work here in Israel during this time. I really love this work. It's really, really interesting. And the most interesting thing is when I see that somehow God uses us as His instruments to show love for these people.
Being able to bless people, it's just been a joy to serve them and to bless them. We have so much. And to see the smiles on their faces, that's what I enjoy. And many times we're able to speak and say, you know, it belongs to the Lord. All the glory belongs to Him.
Because I love these people and I feel like we owe them this debt of love, and I don't want to be silent. I want one life. If one life can make change the world, then I will do that. If God wants me to do that, that's my heart.
Since the inception of Christian Friends of Israel in December of 1985, Sharon and I have purposed in our heart to be a blessing to the people of Israel. God has graciously called alongside of us our brothers and sisters from the nations to stand with us in this ministry of blessing to the Jewish people. We also want to thank those of you who stand with us as well, according to Genesis 12:3, to bless the Jewish people in these last days.
A special thanks to all who made the film possible, our staff in Jerusalem, representatives around the world, and to Hugh Kitson, producer of Jerusalem, the Covenant City. And we do thank you for prayerfully considering supporting this ministry in prayer and in practical ways and helping us to take His love back to the people who brought it to us.
Shalom from Jerusalem.